Chapter 13 is Creation of Dog's Twin, and this is one of the theological chapters, and earlier we saw the Genesis and the Vineyard of Eden, which is kind of a creation story, and then you have an Exodus story, which talks about the creation of dog and the incarnation of dog on Earth. And then this is a story of the creation of dog's twins. So I guess what you're noticing is that when you're outside working in a vineyard doing manual labor all day, you just have all these crazy thoughts that come into your head, and this is something that came in. So I happen to have Bluey the dog's picture. I rescued it from my office, and I brought it home for the quarantine time. And so there's Bluey. So that's the perfect dog. And now we're going to hear this story about creation of dog's twin. Chapter 13. When the good Lord saw that dog was perfect and witnessed all the good man's new friend had done and what an excellent companion dog was for man, the Lord began to feel lonely and decided to make another canine for himself. So he dusted off the mold and took another bone from the sacrificial lamb at the temple's altar and made another dog who sat by his side at the throne. Now the Lord loved this dog as much as the first and blessed him, saying, "You may eat all the fruits and cheeses and cold cuts and smoked salmon and mutton steaks and beasts the priests sacrifice at the altar except for one thing. I have discovered a genetic mutation in your design, and your system cannot metabolize grapes. If you eat grapes, you will sicken and die. Therefore, I forbid you to eat grapes." The dog was obedient and obeyed his master and partook of all the food fed to him by the Lord's hand. And in the kingdom of heaven, dog ate as well as angels and followed the Lord everywhere. At sunrise on an autumn morning, as the Lord walked through the vineyard of Eden, examining grape clusters, pulling leaves on the east side of the vine so the fruit ripened fully in the gentle morning sun, he was surprised to find several bunches mangled, untimely ripped from the mother vine and scattered over the ground. The Lord was saddened to see such waste and destruction of his beloved grapes, and the Lord's tears fell as torrential rains on earth. "Who did this?" thundered the Lord, the heavens rumbling with God's rage, and people on earth were sore afraid. The Lord suspected Satan had entered his perfect vineyard and began searching the ground for cleft hoof marks. He discovered some poop containing grape seeds and grape skins and suspected it was from a raccoon. He summoned the dog, endowed with the best sense of smell in the kingdom, to track down the scoundrel. "Dog, come!" And the dog appeared with his tail between his legs and regurgitated remnants of grape skins mixed with yellow bile. "Why are you sick?" inquired the Lord. "Have you eaten the grapes I commanded you not to eat?" "No, my lord," replied the dog, crossing the fingers of his paws. "I swear to God. Behold, I am the Lord your God, and I know the truth. There are reasons for my laws. I told man not to eat bacon, pork bellies, nor the flesh of swine, because pigs carry disease that will make him sick. Likewise, I commanded you not to eat grapes, for they will sicken and kill you. I gave you everything in the kingdom except grapes, but you, like Adam, disobeyed me, sneaking out at night to steal and cause mischief. And now you lie, taking my name in vain." As the critter cowered under the thundering judgment of the Lord, the Almighty had an epiphany and proclaimed, "You are not a dog. You're different from the dog who serves man obediently on earth. Therefore, you must depart the kingdom of heaven and suffer on earth below, wandering in exile apart from the community of men and dogs. Out with you!" And the Lord picked up the creature and threw him from heaven to earth. And as the animal plummeted downward through the sky, men heard a wicked, cackling laugh and screaming howls and were sore afraid from the frightful sounds, while dogs on earth barked warnings. And God warned his people to stay away from this four-legged animal that was so crafty and lied and was wicked. And men told their beloved dogs to stay away from that creature, saying he was no good. And man called this animal coyote. There's a footnote to the text, so let's read that. Biblical scholars point out when God created the second dog, he didn't infuse him with the Holy Spirit. Therefore, although the same mold was used, dog 2.0 was by nature different and unholy compared to the original version, becoming the first evil twin.